The exciting part about being a chef is exploration. There's nothing better than heading out into the world, discovering new ingredients, and then cooking them right away. That's what makes this such an adventure. Miranda and I both work with food every day, but today we're on assignment for Food & Drink magazine to explore, discover, and taste as much as we can.
Today's great for me because I've been a fan of Food & Drink magazine for years. Dev and I are taking a road trip to Prince Edward County. It's about 2 hours east of Toronto, and it's a haven for people who are passionate about food and drink. We're going to visit 5 stops and pick up ingredients along the way. Then we'll make a meal together that's inspired by the county.
I'm really excited for this dinner that we're gonna have tonight because I'm always hungry and dinner is my favorite meal of the day.
Yeah, we can create something truly special with all the ingredients here. It's gonna be so delicious, I cannot wait.
So this is the Borealis Charmat Method Rosé from Hinterland. The grape is Gamay Noir. Now there's 3 ways of making sparkling wine. Charmat Method is one of the 3, and it's most commonly used in the process to make Prosecco. And Prosecco is actually the most popular sparkling wine, you know, drunk globally.
Thank you for having us. Cheers.
Cheers.
And I'm just gonna smell. I'm the designated driver today, but I want Miranda to have all the fun.
It's so refreshing, super crisp.
So this is really good food wine. You know, you're at 11% alcohol, so you've got great acidity. It's good at palate cleanser, especially when eating these oysters.
I was just gonna ask, why does sparkling wine and oysters, why do they complement one another?
Exactly why. The acidity cleanses the brine. So if you're going to the next course, you don't still have that flavor of oyster because it is a strong flavor, right?
Yeah.
But delicious too.
So this is a perfect pairing?
It is a perfect pairing.
Match made in heaven.
These are Pinot Gris. These usually go into our white cap.
White cap, named after Lake Ontario?
Named after the white caps of Lake Ontario. When you go out there and it's a windy day, the winds come from the southwest here. And when it's a windy day, you can just see it frothing over to remind us of the wine, so we named it after that.
The Borealis Rosé has a slightly fruitier finish than the white cap, but both are crisp and dry and delicious. So we're grabbing a bottle of each to pair with dinner.
Sparkling wine always pairs well with meals in the kind of weather we're having today. We haven't even started figuring out tonight's menu, but these wines are a great starting point. They're really versatile and will work with any seafood, white meats, or veggie dishes.
So at the front over here, we have our cauda. Beside it is our crescenza. In the back, we have the rose haas. Over here is our light hall tome. And the last one is our morning mist. Do you make all the cheeses here?
We do, yeah. So this is our factory. We have a few different styles, from cream cheese to soft cheese, like brie, fetas, and then we have, of course, the classic, like, big wheels that you imagine, and those age anywhere from 2 months to 2 years.
Miranda and I are gonna eat this whole board.
Cannot wait to start eating.
Wonderful.
It looks amazing.
Okay, enjoy.
Thank you so much. Okay, cheers.
Cheers.
This is so good.
There's a ton of variety here at Fifth Town. So many great cheeses with a nice range of flavors and textures. I'm a huge cheese guy, so whatever we don't use for tonight's dinner, it's all coming home with me.
I'm thinking about pairing these cheeses with the sparkling wine from Hinterland, but I'm also thinking about the fresh produce I know we're gonna find here in the county. It's peak season, so I'm thinking tomatoes, corn, peppers, beans. These cheeses will pair well with all kinds of fresh vegetables.
Vicky's driveway. I can't believe there's a business out here.
I grow about 100 different varieties of tomato. This is where it's all grown.
Wow.
Here is Sunrise Bumblebee. Cheers.
Cheers. Wow. Mm-hmm. That was so brightly delicious. Each one is so different.
This is what a fresh carrot tastes like.
So sweet.
And it's cold,
so
too, because it's underground.
Yeah.
You need to pull that carrot. Wrapped out right there. Move it back and forth like that. Yeah! Look at you!
I'm definitely going to work root veggies into a dish tonight. I'm thinking onions, potatoes, and those beautiful radishes at Vicky's. Obviously, these incredible carrots. And by the way, this was my first time picking carrots, and I loved it.
I'm in grocery stores every day buying fresh food, but there's nothing like eating food that is this fresh. It's a completely different experience. Everything tastes better, yes, but it's more than that. You just immediately feel better when you eat it.
This is our still. This is what sets us apart. We have a hybrid still, has a pot as well as columns that help purify the spirit, so we can do whiskeys and vodkas off of the same still, and we keep it busy.
We got some pork shoulder, we got some brisket going.
God. Can you smell
down
it?
Here we got some cider.
We have our vodka that we do with our own wheat, which is nice because we're a farm distillery, so we're able to mill it and then ferment and distill it, which is makes a great soft mouth feel. The gin has lavender from the lavender farm just down the road as its signature botanical.
You can really taste the lavender.
And it balances well with the juniper. We really
it's a beautiful
really
flavor.
And then one of our most popular bottles is actually a cassis that we've done with a local blackcurrant farm. This has really been a direction for us, kind of responding to what people are growing and producing in the county.
So we just got to Sand and Pearl, and it is a truly magical place. It is absolutely bustling tonight.
We have all this beautiful produce that we collected throughout today.
We're gonna cook some food. Deb and I are both making a dish. chef Alana Ferguson is also here, and she's gonna make a dish with us. Also gonna pair a beautiful cocktail with each dish, and then we're all gonna sit down and enjoy a big meal together. Amazing day today in Prince Edward County. We saw 5 beautiful places, but I feel like there are so many more. I feel like year after year, discover new things every single time you come here.
This has really opened up my eyes to the world of artisans, winemakers, cheesemakers, and people who really love their craft and the beautiful products that are available right in my backyard.
I cannot wait to come back.
On my next assignment, I'm headed to Niagara. I can't wait to see what's delicious there.